Morning children, chapter 8 quadrilateral, another condition for a quadrilateral to be a parallelogram. We have studied some conditions while doing the theorem. I'll remind you that one afterwards. Now the new condition for a quadrilateral to be a parallelogram. What is that condition? A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. This is the last theorem for the quadrilateral, that is theorem 8.8, right? So what is the condition here? A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite side is equal as well as parallel also. So let us take AB is parallel to DC as well as AB equal to DC. Got? So AB is parallel to DC is also given, AB is equal to DC also given. So what we will write in the parallelogram ABCD? In parallelogram ABCD, AB parallel to CD, AB equal to CD. Now what we have to prove here? We have to prove that then the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So I repeat the steps. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. So we have to prove that ABCD is a parallelogram. Let us see the proof now. Before starting the proof, what is the definition of a parallelogram? Two pair of opposite sides is parallel, right? We already got one side is parallel, which is that side AB parallel to DC. What is the condition for a parallelogram? Two pair of opposite side is parallel. We got already AB parallel to DC. If we are able to prove that BC is parallel to AD, then we can say that this is a parallelogram. So what we are having now? So we have joined the diagonal. So construction also I should write a construction join AC. I'll write here construction. I forgot to say that one. Join AC. Okay, any diagonal. Now we are getting two triangle. Triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Okay, triangle ABC and triangle ADC. If we go for AB and ADC, they are equal also. AB equal to DC, that is given. Now we know that this is parallel. So what you can say about angle A and angle C? They are also equal. So I'll write here angle A equal to angle C, because this angle A means it is CAB only, and this angle C means it is DCA. So that is also given, or we can write that AB parallel to DC, or alternate interior angle. Anything you can write, because given also correct only, alternate interior angles are equal. So we got the first equal side and the first angle we got. Now we have to need a second side for making this as an included angle. So we are taking that AC equal to AC, that is common. Now what you can say about triangle ABC? Which is the congruence is happening? See, always think about the alternate interior angle. If you identified in a parallelogram, then you can easily write the congruency part. A and C are the alternate interior angle. So in place of A, we can write C. In place of C, we can write A only. So which letter is left now? D. So the criteria is SAS. So we got the triangle ABC congruence into triangle CDA by SAS criteria. Now let us see that what you can say about angle DAC as well as angle ACB. So we have to write angle ACB first, because the triangle ABC we have written first. So if I write angle ACB by CPCT rule, I can write angle A means C, C means A only, it is CAD. Check that one. Angle ACB means here. ACB and CAD. CAD is this one. So by CPCT, these two angles are equal. Now, if you see the figure, this is an alternate interior angle only. So we can write that alternate interior angles are equal. This implies, this CPCT shows that alternate interior angles are equal. Now the question is that then which lines are parallel? Which lines are parallel? Because the angle is this. So this is starting from the line is BC and the transversal is the diagonal. So here BC parallel to, we can write AD, right? Because this angle only that one. This shows that alternate interior angles are equal. Hence what we can write? BC parallel to AD. So equation number one. Now given that, which pair is parallel already given in the question? Given that AB parallel to DC, the question itself is given. Now how many pair of opposite sides parallel you got? Two pair of opposite sides are parallel. So what you can say about ABCD now? ABCD is a parallelogram. What first given? ABCD is a quadrilateral with one pair of opposite side is equal and a parallel. Now what we have got? It is a parallelogram only. Now this is the condition we got. Now the new condition. So what is given in the question? In a quadrilateral, one pair of opposite side is equal as well as parallel. Understood? So then what we can say? ABCD is a parallelogram. So for this we are using SAS concept. The first equal side AB, second equal side is AC, and the included angle is A. So we got AB equal to DC, angle A equal to angle C, alternate interior angle AC equal to AC common. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA by SAS criteria. Now, angle ACB equal to CAD by CPCT rule. Now, if you consider this one, this pair will be an alternate interior angles only. So, what we can say? BC parallel to AD. Already in the question, AB parallel to DC is given. Now, we are getting by these two equations, two pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. Is parallel. So, what is the conclusion? ABCD is a parallelogram. Example 6. ABCD is a parallelogram in which P and Q are the midpoints of opposite sides AB and CD. If AQ intersects DP at S and BQ intersects CP at R, show that the APCQ is a parallelogram. Second one, DPBQ is a parallelogram. Then PSQR is a parallelogram. Now let us see that what is given in the question. ABCD is a parallelogram. So I'll write here given ABCD is a parallelogram. Here the question is too big, so we'll conclude first this one to prove. Little part only we are writing. So the first one is APCQ is a parallelogram. Without seeing the diagram, you can write what is to be proved. Number two, DPBQ is a parallelogram. Third one, PSQR is a parallelogram. Okay, so if the diagram is completed in the textbook first only, we are not taking that one. We are doing part by parts only. So ABCD is a parallelogram, the first sentence, in which P and Q are the midpoints. So we have marked here P and Q only. They have joined in the diagram completely. I am taking this much only because the first part is that APCQ is a parallelogram. APCQ is a parallelogram. So I have joined only this much. APCQ is a parallelogram, right? So what we can say that the last just now only we have learned one theorem, one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. So one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel, we can prove that it is a parallelogram. See, already the question itself is given that ABCD is a parallelogram, right? If ABCD is a parallelogram, the opposite sides are equal as well as parallel. First pair, then second opposite side also equal as well as parallel, right? So this is ABCD parallelogram by the given part. So we have to prove that APCQ only. So let us write that ABCD is a parallelogram. Then we can write that AB parallel to CD and AB equal to CD. That is opposite side. It's a properties of the parallelogram. Opposite side property. What is the opposite side's property? Equal and also parallel. Now my question is that if AB is parallel to CD, what you can say about AP and CQ? See, AP is a part of AB only. So definitely AP is parallel to CQ also. Why? CQ is a part of CD. What we are written here? AB parallel to CD. So what we have taken that APCQ is a parallelogram, we should prove. So we are taking AP as well as CQ only. So AP is a part of AB, CQ is a part of CD. So AP is also parallel to CQ. Now what about this part? AB equal to CD is the, this shows that half of AB equal to half of CD implies half of AB means either I can write AP or I can write BP, but we need APCQ only, right? So we are taking this as a half of AB means AP. Similarly, half of CD means what? CQ and DQ, right? So CQ only we need to prove. So this we will write here CQ. Now you check here, AP and CQ are parallel as well as equal. So what we have studied there, in a quadrilateral, one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. Just now only the theorem completed, right? So one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. Then what we can say that APCQ is a, that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So I'll write the here reason, equation number 1, equation number 2. Using 1 and 2, what is the conclusion? Using 1 and 2, we have one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. Parallel in quadrilateral APCQ. Therefore, APCQ is a parallelogram. Now the second part, DPBQ is a parallelogram. We have joined that much only in this diagram, DPBQ. So the same concept we are using, AB parallel to DC, AB parallel to DC as well as AB equal to DC. So if AB parallel to DC and AB equal to DC, the same way we are taking, whatever we are taken that one. So AP parallel to or BP, here DPBQ is there. So I should write BP parallel to DQ. Right, so if BP if you take, it is a part of AB, and a DQ if you take, then it is a part of DC. So BP parallel to DQ we got. The same idea here also, what we applied last, half of AB equal to half of DC. So what is that one, half of AB, what we required? Either we can write AP and BP. This time we need BP only. So we are writing BP equal to DQ. Again, equation 1 and 2 completed the last time. So I'll make it here 3 and 4. Using 3 and 4, what we can conclude, DPBQ, we should say in the order, DPBQ, either clockwise or a anti-clockwise. So DPBQ is a parallelogram. Now what is the reason for this one? One pair of opposite sides is equal, at the same time it is parallel. So what we got, DPBQ is a parallelogram. This is the reason. So I should write here, proved 2. So one we proved, APCQ was the last time we have proved. Now this time we have proved that DPBQ is a parallelogram. Now the third part of the proof is that PSQR is a parallelogram. Actually the diagram is given like this only in your textbook. We have done step by step only for learning purpose, right? So this is the complete diagram. PSQR is a parallelogram we have to prove, right? So what we have proved first, let me explain that one. PSQR is a parallelogram means we should get that PS parallel to QR, okay, and PR parallel to SQ, right? Opposite sides are parallel, we should get right now. So what we have proved first means APCQ is a parallelogram. If you go for the question, you can see the statement there. We have proved that APCQ is a parallelogram and DPBQ. If you take APCQ, let us see that one. APCQ, AP, okay, 1 minute, APCQ is a parallelogram. So we have to prove now PSQR. What we have to prove? PSQR. If we consider APCQ, that is the first parallelogram, in that way, in PSQR, which part is coming? Check that. APCQ means we are getting PR, right? PR is coming there, as well as CQ. APCQ means you will get a SQ also, right? So we are getting this part. Since APCQ is a parallelogram, we have already proved that these two are parallel only, right? APCQ is a parallelogram means, can I write PC parallel to AQ? PC parallel to AQ. If you consider PC, PR is a part of that one. PR parallel to SQ. Right? First step we have proved that APCQ is a parallelogram. In that we got PC parallel to AQ because opposite side property, opposite sides. So from that what we can write, PR parallel to SQ, that is the equation number. Already we have completed 4 equations, this, so I'll write a 5th only this. Now what is another part? Check PSQR, the another part is SP and QR. So it is coming in DPBQ parallelogram only, right? So I'll write here, what is we have proved? DPBQ is a parallelogram. We have proved in 2. This shows that DP parallel to QB, opposite side. So from DP we want the how much, because we need PSQR, so DP we need SP only, and similarly QB which we want, QR, SP parallel to QR, equation number 6 only. Now you, if you check fifth and sixth equation, PR parallel to SQ we got, and at the same time SP parallel to QR we got in PSQR. So two pair of opposite sides are parallel, parallel, therefore what is the conclusion? PSQR is a parallelogram. Here we have not used the same way, that is one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel, we have not used. We are getting the proof, depending upon the proof 1 and proof 2, we are taking that these two are parallel. So, two pair of opposite sides are parallel. So, therefore, PSQR is a parallelogram. So, we have to prove APCQ, DPBQ, PSQ are all parallelogram only. For that, what is given ABCD is a parallelogram. The idea what we are using here mainly, one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel only. So, ABCD is a parallelogram means AB parallel to CD and BC parallel to AD. So, AB parallel to CD only we are considering. If AB parallel to CD means we can write AP parallel to CQ. BP parallel to DQ, AP parallel to CQ and AB equal to CD also we can take. AP parallel to CQ means parallel side property we have got. Now equal we should bring. So half of AB equal to half of CD, that is AP equal to CQ. So in APCQ, APCQ it's a quadrilateral now. So in that quadrilateral one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. So what is the conclusion? APCQ is a parallelogram. So you can see that it is the complete diagram. While proving I have used only, we have joined APCQ. Now the complete diagram only I am using and explaining the repetition. Now for the second part DPBQ, the same property only we are considering. AB parallel to CD means BP parallel to DQ. Now BP equal to DQ we should get. For that what we are used, half of AB equal to half of DC. So we got the one pair of opposite side, that means BP and DQ are equal as well as parallel. So DPBQ is a parallelogram. So we have to prove the third part, PSQR is a parallelogram. So for proving this third question, we have to use the first two questions. What is the first two question? APCQ is a parallelogram. Second question, DPBQ is a parallelogram. So for PSQR, if you consider, SQ is a part of AQ and PR is a part of CP. Already APCQ is a parallelogram means AQ parallel to CP only. So from that what we can write, PR parallel to SQ, first pair we got. Similarly, the DPBQ is a parallelogram. So that means DP parallel to BQ we got. So if DP parallel to BQ means we know that SP parallel to QR. Now these two equation if you consider, two pair of opposite sides are parallel, therefore PSQR is a parallelogram. So it's a lengthy proof, three parts of the question is there, practice well. With this today's class I'm winding up. Thank you.